this lesson, we will review the major changes to the TBICoE's progressive return to activity clinical recommendation. By the end of this video, you will be able to identify the major changes to TBICoE's progressive return to activity, or PRA, clinical recommendation. There are 6 major changes in the progressive return to activity 2021 revision. First, we have combined several TBICoE products into a single simplified clinical suite. The progressive return to activity for primary care managers, the progressive return to activity for rehabilitation providers, the concussion management tool, and all of their accompanying materials have been combined into a single clinical recommendation. This will allow for providers to make a smooth transition from performing the MACE-2 at the point of injury to using the PRA to manage the concussion across the continuum of care. Next, we have updated the PRA's instruction for progression. Previously, the Neurobehavioral Symptom Inventory, or NSI, was required daily. Now, the service member will complete a self-evaluation each morning by simply asking themselves if they feel the same, better, or worse than the previous day. The service member will only complete the NSI during their scheduled follow-up appointments. We have updated the definition of rest to relative rest, as recent evidence has shown that prolonged complete rest may extend recovery. Next, we clarified activity recommendations and simplified restrictions in each stage to make them more relevant to service members. Additionally, we have included symptom-guided management strategies to provide primary care managers with treatment options for various post-concussive symptoms, as well as guidelines for specialty referrals. And finally, we clarified and expanded the return to duty, or RTD, screening. Previously, service members returned to full duty after passing an exertional test. Now, the service member must pass both a physical screening with an exertional test and a cognitive screening using the Automated Neuropsychological Assessment Metrics, or ANAM. In summary, these changes to the PRA will make it easier for providers to manage the recovery process and return service members with concussion to full duty as quickly and safely as possible. The next video in the sequence will define relative rest.